Hey, how's it going? So I'm on my way to take Sammy to the dog park, and I thought it'd be a good idea to test out the Ulanzi WM-10 wireless microphone. It's a little lav mic with a USB-C connector. I was sitting here describing it for about 5 minutes, and then it occurred to me that you can't actually see the thing from this camera angle. So we're going to go over to the workbench, and I'm going to tell you all about it, and I'll see you back here in a minute.
Hey everybody, welcome back to the workbench. Like I said, this is the Ulanzi wireless microphone WM-10. It's one transmitter, one receiver, in case you didn't read the box. You turn on the transmitter, you plug in the receiver, should be easy peasy. Unless you have an Android phone, I've said before, I'll say it again, do not pair a USB-C wireless microphone like this with an Android phone, because you can't change the gain in Android, so you're always going to blow out the audio and it's going to sound bad. Anyways, the reason I bought this microphone is because I wanted to pair it with my DJI Action 4 camera. So this camera has a USB-C port built right into the side, you plug the receiver in, you turn it on, you set the gain, and it will just work. The receiver hangs out the side a bit more than I would like, but other than that, it's pretty much perfect. At least it's perfect in theory. See, the reason I bought this particular microphone is I wanted a tight, convenient, slim package that would fit inside this small case with the camera so that whenever I take only the camera, I will happen to have a microphone too if I need it. But unfortunately, even though this microphone looks really tiny in pictures, once you get it in your hand, it's a little bit bulkier than you might think when you're buying it. So the first things first, you can pop this windscreen off to help get you a little bit of space. But once we try to put it in here with the camera, we start to realize that, there just really isn't a place for it. Trust me, I've tried every single way. When the camera is in this cage, which is coincidentally also made by Ulanzi, there's just not enough space in the case. But when you take the cage off the camera itself is much smaller, and it'll fit just fine in the case with the microphone. That part is no problem. The problem is that I really like having this cage on the camera because it gives me a regular screw-on mounting point, a GoPro mount, and a cold shoe, none of which is on the camera by default. So even though this microphone does almost exactly what I want it to do, it's just a little bit bigger than I had hoped, and I'm kind of disappointed by the size of it. Also, one downside of being able to store the receiver neatly into the transmitter like this is that when you remove the receiver, you now have this big empty plastic cavity sticking out of the microphone at all times. So when you clip this to your shirt, the microphone hanging off of you is a lot bulkier than it actually needs to be. So anyways, physically, that's the Ulanzi WM-10 microphone. So back to me to see if it's any good.
This is what the microphone sounds like with no noise reduction with the windows open on my car. Now this is noise reduction level 1. Hopefully it cut down on my air noise quite a bit. This is noise reduction level 2. Hopefully it's a bit better. And this is noise reduction level 3. So as we're driving, and I'm coming up to a stop here, you should be able to see how much the noise reduction helps. Alright, now we're back at the stoplight with noise reduction 3 still on. We are back with no noise reduction. We are back at noise reduction level 1. We're just going to leave it at level 1 for the rest of this drive. My camera is a DJI Action 4. And I thought it'd be a really great idea to mount it to the hood of my car. This camera angle does have its drawbacks, but I will be using it for every single future video, especially the ones at the workbench. Although I'll probably need a new windshield to make that happen. One of the drawbacks of living in Colorado Springs is that there's a lot of rocks flying around, a lot of dump trucks, you know, bad roads, potholes. So there's a lot of pitting and scratching and dings all over my windshield. Wanted to get a new windshield for a while, but I've always felt it's kind of pointless when the new one's just gonna be trash in a week anyways. The Ulanzi WM-10 wireless microphone. It's not as small as I had hoped, which is unfortunate, but at least it's very cheap, or at least it was for me. I got it as part of an introductory deal off AliExpress for $8. Although looking at it on Amazon, it's going for $20. So the specs on this microphone are nothing to write home about. 30 feet of range and a 4.5 hour battery life. So what it really needs to have is convenience and price. In terms of price, I would feel a lot better at this at $10 to $15 than $20. I don't know that I would spend $20 on this, but at $8, you know, I was really happy with it, regardless of the size. The convenience is above average, but disappointing for what I wanted. On the plus side, there's no reverb function. A lot of these cheap microphones have an option you click, it makes it echo. You might accidentally click that on and ruin a lot of audio without realizing there's a problem. If it doesn't have reverb, you can't turn it on by accident, so that's a big plus in my book. But one major downside is there's no gain control. So with USB-C, it looks like this would be perfect to pair with an Android phone, but it's not. Don't use a microphone like this with an Android. So you have to buy a microphone with built-in gain control, and that is never going to be an option at this price point. I think the gain control is part of why the Rode wireless microphones are so popular. The difference is that you're going to be paying hundreds of dollars instead of tens of dollars. Another downside to cheap microphones is that there's no standard audio out. So if you don't have a USB-C port that's compatible with it, there's not a whole lot you can do. But fortunately, this camera has a working USB-C port, and it lets you set the gain. So an upside is that I can plug this microphone directly into the camera and it works right out of the box. The camera's gain is set to -2. At 0, the microphone was recording a little bit too hot and I was getting some distortion. Not a lot, but it was noticeable.
Okay, one more thing. When you hear this microphone in the car, you're going to notice an unpleasant buzziness to my voice that makes it almost sound distorted, like the microphone is clipping. But I promise you, the microphone is not clipping. So I opened up this microphone to try and figure out what's going on. And if you're wondering how much of this is empty plastic space, it's this entire black section here. I noticed that the microphone capsule, which is this small surface mount rectangle right here, is sharing this big, empty, plasticky, resonating space with the battery, the connector, the switch, and the switch is loose, it kind of moves around, as well as these two loose wires. So I'm wondering if that by just speaking, something in here is vibrating, either the wires or the switch, and it's resonating inside this little chamber, and that's causing the buzziness. So what I'm gonna do is hot glue down these wires to make sure they're not vibrating around, maybe form a little hot glue chamber around the capsule behind it, and see if I can do anything to pad this button. And hopefully that will eliminate that weird buzzy vibration. So let's give it a shot and see if anything happens. So the trick is make sure no hot glue whatsoever gets on that little capsule. And I think I've accomplished that. Now we're just going to hot glue down the rest of the wire. Why not? Just cover the whole thing. I don't care. Okay, so for the space around the battery, I've got a little bit of carpet foam. We're just going to kind of shove that in there, see if that does anything. It's going to be a little tough to pack it in. There's not that much space. Okay, that probably fills it in a little bit. Now, as for the possibility the switch is rattling, I tried messing around with dampening it by filling it in a little bit with some hot glue, but it wasn't working out in any way that wasn't just gonna get the button stuck. Unfortunately, I don't think there's gonna be much I'm gonna be able to do about that right now. I'm just gonna do a quick before and after to see if these modifications have helped. But remember, the footage in the car was before I did this, so you're gonna hear a little bit of a buzziness behind my voice, if I can even get it back together. Anyways, back to me.
And here we are back at gain -2, just to do a sanity check to see if while we're peaking in yellow, if that's causing any issues. I don't know if that's what's causing it to clip or sound weird or distort. So let's go find out. So right now the camera is set to a gain of -2, which is the setting I was using when I was driving around the car. This should rule out the noise of the car for causing that vibrating sound. What it won't rule out is Sammy's whining. No. Okay, next I'm going to try a gain of -4 and see how that works. All right, here's a modified microphone with a gain of -4. Now, according to the meter on the camera, -4 isn't even peeking into yellow. So if this is clipping, I'd be very surprised, but it also should be at a loud enough level you're not getting any noise from the preamp. I can't hear the output of this microphone right now, so I'm just as curious as you are to see if this has helped. So this is a gain set to -12. I'm not even close to clipping, so this better work. I'm speaking a little bit loudly, and I want to know if this microphone has issues or if the issue is all the noise in the car. So now the gain setting is -12 on the camera. This is about as low as you can reasonably set the gain and still get this microphone to work. And if it buzzes at this point, well then it's always going to buzz. But this is a modified microphone, which hopefully sounds great, we don't have to worry about it, or the modification did nothing and it's a complete waste of time. Let me know. Okay, now we're trying gain level -10, because -12 is too quiet to hear, and I would like to be able to hear if this is buzzy or not. We have no windscreen, so I don't know. But let's give it a shot and see what it sounds like. Hopefully it doesn't clip. So now the camera's gain is set to -10. Let's see if there's any buzzing here. At this level, there's not going to be any clipping, at least from the camera. It doesn't rule out the possibility that the microphone itself is clipping internally before transmitting, at which point there's gonna be nothing that we can do. But hopefully we don't have to worry about that, because hopefully the modifications fix the issue. Okay, here we are back at -6, which was a little quiet, but kind of manageable. Now we're at -6 with noise canceling level 1. Is this still buzzy? I don't know. Noise canceling level 2. Is this buzzy? Is this weird? Is this better? Is this worse? I don't know. And noise canceling level 3. So this might sound weird, or it might sound okay without all the car noise in the background. My question is, does it work? I have no idea. So out of curiosity, is the buzziness caused by the windscreen, because that might vibrate, I don't know. This hollowness though, that really sucks. It might be caused by that too. Let's see if this sounds any better at -2. Okay, one more quick sanity check. I set wind reduction off. That shouldn't have done anything, but we'll see. Gain is -4, and I set it to mono. None of that should have done anything, but let's find out. All right, so the furnace is on, might hear some of that, but is it buzzy? Okay, the camera is insisting that I'm not clipping. I see it right there. The camera is insisting that I'm not clipping, so I've shoved some fabric into this microphone to see if it makes it sound better. So will it buzz if there's a bunch of fabric shoved in this thing? I have no idea. I hope... I don't know.
This is gain of -4. By the way, the camera's audio is set to mono, and wind noise reduction is turned off, but neither of those settings should actually affect this external microphone. So hopefully everything is sounding better, or at least less buzzy, or maybe this modification was a complete waste of time. Let me know in the comments what you think.
All right, so I've just pulled up to the dog park, and Sammy's very excited. Hope you guys enjoyed the ride, and I'll be seeing you again eventually. Let's go.